Exploring the therapeutic benefits of pranayama, yogic breathing, a systematic review. This was printed in the International Journal of Yoga, May to August 2020, and printed in the National Library of Medicine. Abstract background. Pranayama, yogic breathing, has demonstrated numerous beneficial health effects. At present, there are no systematic reviews evaluating the beneficial health effects of pranayama alone as a practice. Aim. The aim of this study is to perform a systematic review about the beneficial health effects of pranayama. Methods. Data were obtained using a stepwise search process by searching the online PubMed, Web of Science, and ScienceVerse Scopus databases using keywords. Controlled clinical trials in humans using pranayama as an intervention with an appropriate control group and evaluating health-related outcomes were selected for inclusion. Results. Initial database searching indicated 669 potentially eligible articles, of which 18 studies satisfying the inclusion-exclusion criteria were selected. All were control trials, of which 13 were randomized and one was a crossover study. Number of participants ranged from 16 to 160. And the duration of pranayama practice varied from 4 days to 6 months. Studies demonstrated a significant effect on cardiorespiratory function in patients with bronchial asthma and the improvement of pulse rate, systolic blood pressure, and respiratory function measurements. Furthermore, reduction in the frequency of attacks, severity, and medication requirement was also observed, with improved quality of life, QOL, in patients with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, symptom activity and impact scores were improved. QOL improvements were also noted in cancer patients. Conclusions. Available evidence on pranayama indicates physiological and psychological benefits. Beneficial effects were mostly observed in patients with respiratory diseases such as bronchial asthma. It also helped those with cancer and cardiovascular disease. However, further high-quality randomized trials are required to provide definitive evidence. Introduction. Complementary and alternative medicine, CAM, is defined by the World Health Organization as the broad set of healthcare practices that are not part of that country's own tradition and are not integrated into the dominant healthcare system. Over the years, the popularity of CAMs has increased globally, with 70 to 80% of the population in developed countries having used some form of CAM during their lifetime. CAMs can be grouped into two broad categories: natural products, herbs, etc., and mind-body practices. Mind and body practices are a group of techniques that are administered or taught by a trained practitioner, and yoga is a practice that falls under this domain. Yoga is a 3,000-year-old spiritual and ascetic discipline, which has gained wider popularity in the recent past as a CAM. It has been designed to bring harmony to the physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual health of an individual. Therapeutic yoga is defined as the application of yoga postures and practice to the treatment of health conditions to prevent, reduce, or alleviate structural, physiological, emotional, and spiritual pain, suffering, or limitations. Hatha yoga, the most widely practiced and studied form of yoga in the modern world, emphasizes two main aspects: asana, physical postures, and pranayama, breathing exercises. Pranayama is a Sanskrit word formed by the cognition of two words, namely prana, meaning breath of life, vital energy, and ayama, meaning expansion, regulation, control. It is the yogic art of breathing, consisting of the deliberate modifications of the breathing process, such as rapid diaphragmatic breathing, slow, deep breathing, alternate nostril breathing, and breath holding retention, which are usually done in a seated posture. Pranayama practices for important aspects of breathing, such as purukha, inhalation, rakaka, exhalation, antakambuka, internal breath retention, and bahakambuka, external breath retention. According to the Yoga Sutra Patanjali, which is the most authoritative book on yoga in India, pranayama is the fourth limb of the eightfold holistic process defined as yoga. Although yoga has been practiced for thousands of years in India, its recent popularity has led much speculation on the effects on the health of individuals, leading to a multitude of studies investigating the impact of these practices on various diseases. The majority of the research studies and reviews evaluating the health benefits of yoga have considered yoga asana and pranayama as a whole, without focusing on pranayama solely. Pranayama alone has demonstrated numerous beneficial health effects, including stress relief, beneficial cardiovascular effect, improved respiratory function, and enhanced cognition. However, at present, there are no systematic reviews evaluating the beneficial health effects of pranayama alone as a practice. Therefore, this present study aims to perform a systematic review of the studies done about the beneficial health effects of pranayama. Pranayama in patients with respiratory disease. There were 6 studies comparing the effects of pranayama in patients with bronchial asthma, whereas 1 study each individual include patients with COPD and pleural effusion, respectively. Bhatt and Ramvar evaluated the effects of pranayama on ventilatory functions in patients with bronchial asthma. Patients with asthma were divided equally into 2 groups, and the intervention group followed pranayama in addition to medication for 3 months. Pulse rate, systolic blood pressure, diastolic blood pressure, respiratory rate, peak expiratory flow rate, forced expiratory volume in the first, and forced vital capacity were determined in all participants. Test results revealed a significant improvement in PR, in post-test values compared to pre-test values in the intervention group. However, no significant changes were reported in the control group. A similar study by Saxena and Saxena were evaluated the effect of pranayama in patients mild to moderate bronchial asthma for 12 weeks. They were measured all participants in the initial stage, and after 12 weeks, a significant reduction in symptoms improvement was observed in the intervention group as compared to the control group after the practice of pranayama. Pranayama in patients with malignant diseases. A total of 5 studies assessed the short-term effects of pranayama in patients with malignancy and evaluated cancer-related fatigue, emotional changes, quality of life, antioxidant status, and immune functions. 3 studies were reported in patients with breast carcinoma, whereas the other studies involved patients with different types of malignant diseases undergoing chemoradiotherapy. Chabradri and others assessed the effect of pranayama on cancer-related fatigue and emotional aspects of breast cancers patients undergoing radiation therapy. Fatigue levels was assessed using the Cancer Fatigue Scale, and emotional aspects were assessed using 5 items as part of the assessment of cancer-related fatigue. The study indicated a significant difference in the pre- and post-test scores of cancer-related fatigue in the interventional group compared to the control group. Furthermore, a significant reduction in emotions such as worry, anxiety, and frustration was reported in breast cancer patients who performed pranayama compared to the control group. The effect of pranayama on antioxidant status was also evaluated in the same group of patients. The results revealed that the interventional group had significantly higher post-test levels of serum protein thiols compared to the control group. Dhruva and others tested the effects of pranayama on quality of life in patients receiving cancer chemotherapy. Patients receiving 2 consecutive cycles of cancer chemotherapy, cycle A and B, were randomized to receive pranayama immediately, interventional group, and after a waiting period, control group. The control group received only usual care following cycle A and pranayama along with usual care in cycle B. The symptom and quality of life measures were self-administered. Fatigue level were measured using the revised Piper Fatigue Scale. Sleep disturbances of the participant was measured using the General Sleep Disturbance Scale. Anxiety and depression were measured by means of the 14-item Hospital Anxiety and Depression Scale. Stress was measured using the Perceived Stress Scale, and the short form 12 version was used to measure quality of life. The study results indicated significant improvements in sleep disturbance, level of anxiety, and mental, and the participants who followed yoga breathing between the 2 consecutive cycles of chemotherapy, the interventional group. The effect of pranayama on immune function of cancer patients in remission was assessed by Coca Pillar. The cancer patients who had completed the standard treatment had statistically significant increase in natural killer cells at 12 and 24 weeks of practice of pranayama and Sirdarshan Kriya, with no similar effect observed in the control group. Pranayama in patients with cardiovascular diseases. Anitha conducted a hospital-based study to evaluate the effect of pranayama on the level of anxiety in patients presenting with myocardial infarction. Standardized Spielberger State Anxiety Rating Scale was used to assess the level of anxiety. The study reported a statistically significant improvement in post-test anxiety in the interventional group compared to the control group. Similar beneficial results on anxiety were observed in another study on patients undergoing coronary angiography, where the mean anxiety score of the interventional group was significantly decreased after performing pranayama, but not in the control group. Gail and others carried out a study to evaluate the effect of pranayama on PR, blood pressure, and rate pressure product, RPP, in mild hypertensive patients. SPB decreased significantly in the intervention group, and the decrease was significant as compared to control group. PR decreased significantly in both the groups as compared to baseline. However, the decrease was similar in both groups. RPP decreased significantly in both groups as compared to baseline. However, the decrease was significantly more in interventional group when compared to the control group. A hospital-based RCT in Moyer and others investigated the effect of slow and fast yogic breathing exercises on blood pressure and autonomic function in patients with essential hypertension. Patients with stage 1 hypertension were equally divided into 3 groups: group 1 control group, whereas group 2 and group 3 followed slow and fast breathing exercises, respectively, for 3 months. The study results revealed a significant decrease in SBP and DBP in both group 2 and group 3. However, the decrease was greater in group 2, with no significant changes observed in control group. Pranayama in other groups of patients. Franz Blau and others tested the short-term effect of having battered women provide testimony about their abuse and or the effects of yoga breathing on depression, which was measured by the Beck Depression Inventory. Participants who self-identified as verbally, emotionally, physically, and or sexually abused within the past 2 years were assigned into four groups as testimony only, yogic breathing only, testimony and yogic breathing, and control. The study results indicated a significant reduction in post-test BDI scores in groups who underwent yogic breathing, giving testimony, and the combination of both, but not in the control group. Discussion. The present systematic review is the first to systematically evaluate the literature on the beneficial health effects of pranayama yogic practice. We observed a significant effect on the cardiorespiratory functions, a pattern of bronchial asthma, and the improvements in PR, SBP, FVC, FEV1, and PEFR. Furthermore, reduction in the frequency of attacks, severity, and medication requirement was also observed, in addition to improved quality of life. In patients with COPD, symptom, activity, and impact scores were improved with pranayama practice. Quality of life improvements have been noted in cancer patients with improved emotions, fatigue, sleep, and reduced anxiety. Reduction in anxiety has also been observed in patients with cardiovascular diseases. In patients with hypertension, both SBP and DBP were reduced with pranayama practices. Hence, the available evidence from controlled studies indicates both physiological and psychological benefits of pranayama. The predominant beneficial effect of pranayama practice was observed in patients with respiratory illness, such as bronchial asthma. Several mechanisms are thought to be responsible for the beneficial respiratory effects of pranayama. Pranayama may allow bronchial dilation by correcting abnormal breathing patterns and reducing muscle tone of respiratory muscles. Furthermore, yoga training is likely to improve the strength of expiratory as well as inspiratory muscles, with resultant improvement in pulmonary function. For example, Bhastrika pranayama is a type of breathing in which one breath rapidly and forcefully, exercising both inspiratory and expiratory muscles. Furthermore, breathing exercises like Kapalabhati, which utilizes the abdominal and diaphragmatic muscles, train the subject to make full use of diaphragm and abdominal muscles in breathing. This is also likely to help in the removal of secretions from bronchial tree and navel, making room for more air. Lung inflation near to total lung capacity is known to be a major stimulus for the release of lung suffocant into alveolar spaces, leading to increased lung compliance. The slow and gentle breathing in some of the pranayama techniques reduces frictional stress, thereby stabilizing the mast cell degranulation, thereby reducing airway inflammation and airway obstruction. The deep inspiration, retention of air, and slow expiration increases the overall capacity of the lungs and gradually improves the pulmonary functions. This improved pulmonary functions is likely to be responsible for the observed reduction in severity, frequency, and medication requirement in patients with bronchial asthma, which ultimately is responsible for the enhanced quality of life in these patients. The improvements observed in COPD are also likely to be due to similar mechanisms. However, it's important to note that there's been a case report of occurrence of pneumothorax with practice of Kapalabhati pranayama. Hence, appropriate selection of the most suitable pranayama methods, careful supervision, and training may be required in patients with already compromised respiratory functions. Another long-term effect of pranayamic breathing is the improvement in autonomic function. Recent controlled trials suggest that yoga training programs can reduce perceived stress, improve mood, and lower catecholamine and cortisol levels, cardiovascular response to stress, blood pressure, and other indices of sympathetic activation in both healthy and clinical populations. Yogic practices shift the autonomic nervous system balance from primarily sympathetic to parasympathetic by directly enhancing parasympathetic output, possibly through vagal stimulation, resulting in positive changes in cardiovagal function and associated neuroendocrine, hemodynamic, and inflammatory profiles in sleep and affect, and in related downstream metabolic parameters. Slow pranayamic breathing generates inhibitory signals and hyperpolarizing current within neural and non-neural tissue by mechanically stretching tissues during breath inhalation and retention. It is likely that these inhibitory impulses, in cooperation with hyperpolarization current, initiate the synchronization of neural elements in the central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, and surrounding tissues, ultimately causing shifts in the autonomic balance towards parasympathetic dominance. This shift in parasympathetic dominance is likely to be responsible for the observed cardiovascular effects of pranayama practice, such as reduced heart rate, SBP, and DBP in patients with hypertension. Our results also indicate several psychological benefits of pranayama practice, including improved emotional responses, fatigue, stress, and reduced anxiety in cancer patients, as well as in patients with cardiovascular disease. Increased melatonin production after a regimen of slow breathing pranayamic exercises has been attributed to pranayama's tendency to create a sense of relaxation and well-being in the subject. Breath holding, an essential part of pranayama, is known to induce theta waves in the electroencephalography. The particular contribution of pranayama to state stress anxiety reduction might also be contributed by the sympathetic parasympathetic shift. Vagal afferents from peripheral receptors are connected with the nucleus tractus solitarius, from which fibers ascend to the thalamus, limbic areas, and in anterior cortical areas. During controlled breathing, the stretch of lung tissue produces inhibitory signals in the vagus nerve, which ultimately shifts the autonomic nervous system into parasympathetic dominance that results in a calm and alert state of mind. Furthermore, during both fast and slow types of pranayama practice, when participants intentionally focus on breathing at different frequencies of respiration and intend to relax, attention is drawn away from extraneous distracting stimuli, Hence, it is evident that the beneficial psychological effect observed with pranayama practice is likely to be a result of both neurohumoral mechanisms, predominantly involving the sympathetic parasympathetic nervous system. The present study has several notable strengths, including the comprehensive and easy replicable search strategy applied to three major medical databases. In addition, we systematically selected the studies through the application of well-defined inclusion-exclusion criteria. However, there are several limitations that need to be considered before drawing conclusions from the results of the present analysis. There was minimal uniformity between the different studies, the yogic interventions, outcomes assessed, study populations, sample sizes, and duration of intervention in the studies was heterogeneous. This prevented the authors from conducting a meta-analysis of the included studies. Furthermore, in the quality assessment using the PEDRO scoring system, the majority of the studies had a poor and fair score. However, one of the reasons for the low scores in these studies might have been the use of single blinding due to the inherent nature of the studies. Conclusions. Pranayama is a simple, cost-effective method with evidence indicating the presence of therapeutic benefits for diseased populations. The available evidence indicates both physiological and psychological benefits. Beneficial effects were mostly observed in patients with respiratory diseases such as bronchial asthma. It also helped to reduce fatigue, anxiety, and other emotional responses in those with cancer and cardiovascular disease. However, the studies were heterogeneous in terms of the methodological quality, pranayama technique used, and sample size. Therefore, further high-quality RCTs are required to provide definitive evidence and also enable a deeper understanding of the underlying mechanisms of the therapeutic benefits of pranayama. Financial support and sponsorship was through the National Institutes of Health's library, and there were no conflicts of interest.